Hello everyone, I welcome you all to Geeky Script. Today I am going to show you how to use Visual Studio Code for C and C++ programming. So I am going to show you how to write a Hello World C++ program and how to run that within Visual Studio Code. So do watch the video till the end. I can guarantee if you watch the video till the end, you'll be learning a lot of new things. And if you're still facing any issues in middle, you can always ask me on comment sessions. And I'm also on Instagram now, so you can also follow me over there. You can ask all of your doubts over there as well. I'm definitely going to help you. So now to use Visual Studio Code for C and C++ programming, you need to first install a couple of software. One is Mingw and Visual Studio Code itself. So just simply go to your favorite browser and to search over here, Mingw download, hit enter. So that will show you the sourceforge.net. So click on this Mingw minimalistic GNU. So that's going to redirect to the official site of sourceforge.net. So here you need to just click on this download button and immediately will see that your file to get download within 3 seconds. So you can see that it's rightly downloaded. So that's how you download Mingw. Next that will need is Visual Studio Code. Just open a new tab and type Visual Studio Code download, hit enter. So that will show you this download Visual Studio Code. Just simply click on that and that will redirect to this page. Here you will get a download button for Windows. So just simply click on that and thanks for your download, and you'll see Visual Studio Code is also rightly started downloading. I have already downloaded it, so I'll cancel it. I'll minimize my browser and you can see both our Mingw and Visual Studio Code are rightly downloaded. So let's install it one by one. So let's start with Mingw. Just double click on it. So here just simply click on install. So keep everything as default. Click on continue. So that will start downloading some of the files. So let's wait for a minute. So you can see that all these files are actually downloaded. So just simply click on continue over here. So that will open this Mingw installation manager. So here under package you will see all these different options. So you need to select this checkbox and click on mark for installation. So the first one is rightly marked. So let's repeat the same process for all these different options. So select it, click on mark for installation, repeat, and the final one as well. So all options are rightly marked. Now go to installation and click on apply changes. So that will show you this window. Click on apply and you can see that our download is rightly began, right? So again, it will take some time, about 3 to 4 minutes, I would say. So let's wait for some time to get it finished. So we'll come back. And now you can clearly see that our Mingw setup is rightly completed. So you can just simply click on close now. You can also close this Mingw installation manager as well. So now that our Mingw is rightly installed, it's time to set environment path. So for that, just go to search and type, environ. So that will show you this edit the system environment variable. So just go there and click on this environment variables over here and click on path and then click on edit. So that will open this edit the environment variable over here. And now you need to paste a path over here, your Mingw bin folder path over here. So to get that path, you need to go to your C drive and you need to click on this Mingw folder. So just double click on that, you'll get a bin folder here. Go inside and to select this path, so right click and copy this path, minimize it and just simply click on new over here and right click and paste that Mingw/bin folder path over here. Now just simply click on OK, then again OK, and then again OK. And now we just know that your Mingw is rightly installed. So now it's time to install Visual Studio Code. So just simply go back to our folder. So here Visual Studio Code we have, we need to install it. Double click on it, accept the license agreement, click on next, next, again next. You need to select all these different options and click on next. So ready to be installed, click on install. Our installation is rightly begun. So by the time it gets installed, I'll request you to subscribe our channel Geeky Syntax. So here also regularly I'm posting a lot of coding related videos. So don't forget to subscribe our channel Geeky Syntax. And also I am posting a lot of videos on WordPress. So I highly recommend you to watch my other videos on WordPress as well. So some of the videos are 1 hour 30 minute video, some are in series. So I highly recommend you to watch all these different videos on our channel. Alright. So yeah, So now you can see that our Visual Studio code is directly installed. Also launch Visual Studio option is directly enabled. Just simply click on finish. So that will launch our Visual Studio code over here. You can see it is directly launched. So let's close this welcome note and let's click on this Explorer and click on open folder over here. So that will open this open folder window over here. Just simply go to your desktop and create a new folder, and let's name this folder as CPP. So for C++, CPP, select that folder, and that folder will get opened over here. Click on items, the authors and all. So folder is directly open. Click on this icon to create a new file, and let's name this file as prog.cpp for C++. All right, so immediately we'll see this prog.cpp directly opened, and it is also telling a suggestion to install this plugin. So just simply click on install over here. So that going to immediately redirect to C and C++ extensions pack over here. So you can see it is directly started installing, right? So let's wait for a minute over here, and you can see that it is directly installed. Next thing that we'll need is code runner. So select this address bar, just to do Ctrl A and delete all the stuff, and just simply type code runner. So that will show you the suggestion called code runner. So just select that and click on install. So we are going to install code runner, and that is also directly installed. So now both of our plugins, C and C++ extensions by Microsoft and code runner, is directly installed. So let's write a simple hello world C++ program over here. So hash include iostream, and then we have created a int main method, and there we are just simply printing hello world. So std colon colon c out, and then we are printing our desired output, and finally we are returning 0. Alright, so just simply write this much and go to file and save this file, and just simply right click over here and click on run code. So that going to immediately start running, and it's going to show you the output on your console over here. So whatever you are going to write over here, so that same output is what you are going to get over here. So let's say you are changing anything, like let's say you are changing from hello world to hello everyone, and you need to go to file and save this file, and you right click and click on run code again, and this time you will get an output called hello everyone on your console. Alright, so in this way you can easily install latest version of MingW, then install Visual Studio Code, and you can set up your Visual Studio Code for C and C++ programming. So in this video I have showed you how to set up for C++. Similar process will be there for C program as well. Only thing is you need to save this file as .c. Alright, and all other step will be same. And obviously you need to write a C program over here instead of C++. So that's the only difference. All other things will be totally same. So that's pretty much all about this video. Don't forget to subscribe our channel Geeky Syntax and our main channel Geeky Script. And you can also subscribe our Geeky Script blogging channel. And also I am posting a lot of videos on WordPress. So don't forget to watch all these different videos on our channel as well. And lastly, special thanks to the supporters of our channel. We are truly grateful to you guys. Supports like this really motivate us to create and improving these videos. Again, thanks a lot for being an essential part of our journey. So that's basically all about this video. Thank you very much for watching this video, and God bless you all.